Nice to see you guys, Aslan Historian here. Today, when we think about the cradle of mankind, our sights turn to Africa, where the oldest members of our lineage have been found. But we need to remember that the idea of Africa as the original homeland of humankind is pretty recent. For almost a century, scientists looked for the origins of humans in Asia, following what's today known as the Out of Asia theory. They also looked for the roots of human evolution in Europe, where a fraudulent skeleton known as the Piltdown Man fooled scientists for decades. Even though human-like fossils had been discovered in Africa as early as the 1920s, racist prejudices against the continent's indigenous population would lead scientists to ignore or reject the African discoveries and reject Africa as the most likely candidate for being the original homeland of humankind until the mid-20th century. Something that few remember, though, is that there was a fourth candidate for being humankind's original homeland, and that place was South America. How did South America came to be proposed as the original homeland of humankind is the story that concerns us today. And in order to understand that, please come with me to know the life and work of one of the most fascinating scientists in the history of Latin America, Florentino Meghino. Florentino Meghino was born in 1854 in the city of Luján, near Buenos Aires, in Argentina. Son of Italian immigrants, Meghino showed an early aptitude for school, something that allowed him to become a teacher in 1869, at only 15 years old, and become the principal of his school at 17. From his office, he would contact himself with academics from Buenos Aires and from overseas, especially from France, including Paul Jourbet and his son, Henri Jourbet. In 1878, some years after leaving his job as a school principal, he would visit France, country in which he would get in touch with ideas of natural selection of Charles Darwin, which were taking hold in the French Academia thanks to scientists like Pierre-Paul Broca and his colleagues. From the French Academia, Meghino would also get in touch with the work of Louis Laurent Gabriel de Mortillet, prestigious archaeologist and anthropologist who was among the pioneers in the study of prehistory. One of the Mortillet's most controversial ideas was the proposal of a tertiary man, an ancestor of modern humans called Anthropopithecus that would have lived around 3 million years ago. Meghino, an enthusiast of the study of fossils since his early youth, would embrace the Mortillet's ideas, and after his return to Argentina in 1881, along with his brother Carlos, he would dedicate himself fully to the study of the fossil mammals from the so-called Southern Cone. Before returning home, he would publish in Paris a monograph titled La Antigüedad del Hombre en el Plata, in which, based on his own studies before and during his stay in France, he affirmed that South America was the center of an ancient explosion of mammalian diversity around 130 million years ago. His proposal of a great South American mammal genesis also included the very own ancestors of humans, an idea he would develop over the following decades. Meghino would eventually propose that early prosimians would have emerged in the South American continent during his Great Speciation event 130 million years ago, which would lead to the emergence of early protohumans in the same continent around 25 million years ago, more concretely in the Pampas region in present-day Argentina. During the next decade, along with his research on prehistoric South American mammals, Meghino continued elaborating his hypothesis on the Pampean origin of humans. In 1889, he presented his own cladogram on the evolution of primates, in which he presented his own five stages for human evolution: the tetraprotomo, the triprotomo, the diprotomo, the protomo, and finally the genus Homo as we know it. In said cladogram, he not only named his proposed protohuman genera, but also detailed the characteristics that said organisms should present according to his deductions and according to his interpretations of the human remains found in Argentina by himself and his colleagues. Like the Latigraman, who
which he identified as a holotype of Homo Pompeius, an immediate ancestor of modern humans, and the Necochea skulls, which he identified as the Diplodomo platensis.
Ameghino even proposed that the human lineage had its earliest ancestors in a genus of fossil primates he named Homunculus, which lived in Patagonia in the early Miocene, and which modern scientists think it's more closely related to modern-day huacaris and saquis. After decades of building up his proposal, Ameghino presented his conclusions at the 17th International Congress of Americanists held in Buenos Aires in 1910. In that congress, he presented his hypotheses and his evidence, which included ancient human remains and what Ameghino believed to be incredibly ancient stone tools found at Sierra de la Ventana in the province of Buenos Aires. Said evidence was analyzed by Austro-Hungarian anthropologist Alex Hartlicka, whose theory of an East Asian origin for the Native Americans clashed directly with Ameghino's proposal of a South American cradle of humankind. In 1912, Hartlicka published Early Man in South America, a book in which he exposes his conclusions on Ameghino's work. After analyzing the evidence offered by the Argentine scientist, Hartlicka concluded that Ameghino had committed several errors, like mistaking an intentional cranial deformation for a natural characteristic of some of his specimens, and making unfounded claims on the antiquity of the bones and the stone tools, as there was no geological or anthropological evidence to back the age Ameghino had assigned to his materials. Ameghino didn't live to give an answer to Hartlicka's book, as he died in 1911 from diabetes-related complications. His idea of a South American cradle of humankind in the Argentine Pampas was discarded in the mainstream academia, but his work on prehistoric South American mammals is still object of admiration and recognition around the world. After the rejection of Ameghino's hypothesis in 1912, scientists still looked for the cradle of humankind in Eurasia until the exposure of the Piltdown Man hoax in 1953, which helped to bring attention to the discoveries made in Africa, which gained increasing credibility as the possible cradle of humankind after the acceptance of the Tang child as an early hominid in 1947. With the time, the out-of-Africa model became the mainstream theory on human evolution and prehistoric settlement around the world, gradually pushing previous proposals like the out-of-Europe model proposed by Hartlicka into obsolescence. Ameghino's proposal for a South American origin of humans has been long abandoned indeed, but it has its place in the history of science, and it also has a pretty special place in the history of Latin American academia. The so-called autochthonist theory of Ameghino is regarded as one of the first serious oppositions against the Euro-Asia model, bringing attention to the possibility that humanity could have its roots in a continent which indigenous inhabitants had been regarded with contempt under the traditional racist views that had dominated academia since the 17th century. Also, even though it was eventually discarded, Ameghino's theory helped bring attention to the development of science in Latin America, a region that has been home to great men and women of science that, like Ameghino, deserve recognition for their contributions to social and technological progress for Latin America and for the entire world. Thanks for watching this video, guys. If you want more content like this, please don't forget to like and subscribe. This has been Aslan Historian. See you next time.